Lopez, welcome to OEM Cartoons. In today's episode, I'm going to tell you about something that happened to me once. One time when I was walking outside a store, there was this kid, not just any kid, a little kid, that went into a store and caused havoc. I was like, what? Do you really have to? Are you kidding me? Do you really have to literally ruin a store just because you want to find a box of cereal? And that wasn't even postponed. Here's progress. Roll it! Well, I'm back. How was that episode of Rugrats? That was so cool how Tommy got away with what he did when he was all the way in wrecking havoc again on the store. At least he got his reptile cereal. How about that? So, I remember that's what the kid did. Let me listen to you, children. Don't do that in stores. So, I know you guys won't steal, but I mean, like, don't wreck havoc in the store. It's bad for you. Be right back after the break. More oh yeah, after this. I'm the spookiest pumpkin anyone's ever seen. Welcome back to OEM Cartoon. Sorry if I was talking to myself again. Well, I wasn't talking to myself. I was just pretending to be a spooky pumpkin. As in the next cartoon I think we're about to see would do something like that. The Bernstein Bears. And I'm not talking about the plain old side G for PBS kids. I'm talking about the Bernstein Bears we had way back before that. They've been better. From 1985. In this episode, I think Papa Bear is going to make the spookiest pumpkin and win. So let's see if I was right, shall we?
The biggest pumpkin head of all.
Isn't that awesome? He learned his lesson from something that he shouldn't have done at all. Panic! And tries to hard work in a pumpkin contest. Papa Bear is a cool dude. Bear and sister are great cubs. And Papa Bear, rawr. More oh yeah, after the break. Man, I need some coffee. Cameron Lopez, see you next time on Oh Yeah. Nice to people. Get back. Hello, everyone. I told you
see Mr. Krabs didn't care about the children, he cared about his money, and he didn't promise to kiss Krabby Clown. Well, if I were him, I would want to be nice to all of them, even my employee SpongeBob. That's just how Mr. Krabs is. No wonder he's off guard sometimes. But we'll be back after the break with more. Oh yeah, cartoons, I promise.
Ah, no! I don't want to get jinxed! Get away!
Oh, sorry guys. I thought someone was about to jinx me. Not that I'm talking to myself or have an imaginary friend. But this next cartoon gave me an idea to act out for you. What scenes? Him! He's a jinx! Because in this next cartoon, TJ and his fourth grade pals are going to deal and have to be with this peanut butter eating little kid who loves to eat peanut butter a lot. And they think he's a bad influence. But is he really a kid? Let's check out and see if they're right or wrong. Feel bad for those kids. Welcome back to OEF Cartoons. After this long episode of recess, I felt bad for them. Then, first the peanut butter kid, broken glasses, sloppy joint on the floor, broken baseball, bat, a muddy baseball, etc. Well, at least they always had fun in the fourth grade, and at least they stopped getting jinxed after. Probably the girls stopped leaving in a long time. But yeah, I was so lucky I wasn't me. Because if that was me, that would be awkward. More OEM cartoons after the break. Hey, Andy Mac, we're still ready for lunch? OEM cartoons. I will tell you right now about the next cartoon. Well, it's about these two bees, a boy and a girl, two best friends. They both love each other for friendship, and they're going on a field trip with all their classmates. It is so rad that they all are going on this field trip that you will want to watch this on and record this on your DVR again and again and again. Here is Maya the Bee, rolling.
Congratulations, my dear Willie.
Yay!
Lopez, see you next time on Oh Yeah Cartoons. Check that out.
Oh, you're back. Welcome. How was that SpongeBob cartoon? I'm glad he got his job there, don't you get me wrong. When I got my first job, it was hard. Tough to get that job as an employee myself. Except I was a friendly cashier in the airport, but didn't go out. I didn't get fired. I didn't quit. Okay, I quit, but still. Difference is, I'm a cool guy. I do acting. That's what I'm here for. Just for you. I'm here for bizarre work. I'm here for everything. So, we'll be back for more OAI cartoons. Just gotta say, I'm here for you too. So I promise that.
Oh, my parents.
Sorry, I'm back. Welcome back to OAI cartoons. I'm here a little bit. How about talk about parents these days? Don't you know how embarrassing they are? When they say, that's my son, or, hey Cameron, how are you? I'm making smoothies. And the father comes like, what? Now that's just awkward these days. I'm sure parents I have parents what I'm like, which they are to parents, but also from the Wonder Years. There are two shows, Kevin and Winnie. Man, my parents are so weird sometimes. But do you want to know whose parents are more worse than mine? Check out Spinelli for Reset. Check it out.
The one night of the year when all parents meet again.
How was Recess? Recess was great when Spinelli's parents finally admit that they were wrong about embarrassing Stilly's daughter. Which, I never said that much about that because my parents are awesome. Kevin and Winnie are meant for each other and they raised me great. Awesomely great. And I feel bad for what I said about them though, especially Spinelli's, because they're not so bad after all. After all, nobody's perfect. More OAI after this. OAI cartoons. I'm Cameron Lopez on a tour of Disney Channel for where I first started out as an actor. For sure, you might not know me as My Love for Tori's special gum star, but. And Disney Channel Cartoon Network, etc. Besides that show, My Love for Tori. Anyway, here's the picture of Phineas and Ferb when they first began. This is like probably the pilot, Phineas. And here's Miles Murphy's Law, how they came off to be after Phineas and Ferb, starring Sabrina Carpenter and more. And here's me and, oh, nothing to see here, just me and Roland Blanchard from Kablam. Anyway, here's our last cartoon of the night, Mina and the Count. Count.
One thing to
watch,
and I'm Cameron Lopez, and we'll see you next time on Oh Yeah Cartoon.
About my Martin Luther King speech, I have a dream that
things will go as great as they were back then. And I'm not talking about way back then, I'm talking about the 90s. And I liked them all through the years, except for the gunshots fired in the night. But I'm not going that far, so.
I'm not in time already. I don't even swear. All I said,
we'll be back tomorrow, yeah. Hey, welcome back to Oh Yeah Cartoons. I'm Cameron Lopez of the Cafe of Disney Channel. And I just finished eating an awesome meal with Andy Mack and her friends. We had baby back ribs and fries. Home fries in French. So, about my next cartoon. This particular cartoon has to do with my bee named Maya. And she was my favorite since I was a little kid from watching the old Nickelodeon on YouTube. Since we don't have, like, the touch phones back then. This was from the 70s to the 90s. Here's Maya the bee. Restore. Let's want to see what happens. Roll it. One beautiful bee, and we're back to clear. So, hopefully don't teach a lesson to us that we can't just let things, think that things will grow overnight, kind of like what I found out on an episode of Reruns one, which we'll be having a surprise soon, coming up right after this. There is no such thing as moose on the backyard. There's no such thing. Once again, welcome back. I'm Cameron Lopez, and how are you guys? This particular thing, next cartoon is going to be about four babies who travel on an adventure together and can talk when their grown-ups aren't around. As their parents and their adults. Here is something that I loved watching as a kid, and I love watching to this day. Here is Rugrats Merlin! Thanks for watching. I'm Cameron Lopez, and we'll see you next time on Oh Yeah Cartoons.